Welcome back to some new r/petty revenge stories, where people share small victories over those who wronged them. I hope you had a great day. The first story is called Manager's Baby. Years ago, I worked for a large retail chain, under your typical promoted because he's one of the boys manager. He didn't do much that actually needed doing in our department, and even foisted things like employee reviews, product resets, counts, etc. off on me. He mostly hung out with his buddies and chatting with customers, although he didn't sell much, because he always tried to push everyone towards the highest end product, even if a more moderate one would suit the customers better. The company rewarded him with prizes like trips and gadgets for our high sales. Sales that I largely made with a team I trained. And then he would brag about all the cool stuff he got. I didn't like him much. One thing he loved talking about constantly was his baby, maybe 9 months old. He even made a picture of the little one, the wallpaper on our display computer. I get being a proud papa. But on top of me already being annoyed with him for being a bad boss, his baby was weird looking. Nothing was wrong with the baby health-wise, but it was bug-eyed and big-headed, like its daddy. This was especially highlighted because babies are already naturally a little like that. And I had to look at a picture of it all day, and all the customers saw it. So I went into our photo editing software and increased the size of the kid's eyes by about another 10%. Not enough for daddy to notice, but enough that it was startling if you were seeing the picture for the first time. People would suddenly react when the boss man showed them the picture and talked about the kid. Like they wanted to say something, but knew they should not. It was small, it was petty, and I still giggle about it years later. Hopefully the kid grew up to look like mama. The next story is called Mandatory Last Minute. 15 years ago, I worked at a company that had regular mandatory training courses throughout the year. They always gave us plenty of notice, and we, co-workers, would usually carpool together to make the 1 hour drive less boring. And it also saved the company money, as they paid for mileage. There would be 5 employees in 1 vehicle, which was fine. But after a few years, the company became really concerned with their profit, and seemed to no longer care about the employees. So one day, they decided that employees had a mandatory training, but it was the following day, a Saturday, with not even 24 hours notice. They didn't care that we all had plans and families. The training was mandatory, so I went to every employee and shared my concern that tomorrow was way too short notice to carpool. I made sure we were all aware that it was too late to arrange a carpool for the 1 hour drive. We would all have to drive ourselves. So the next day, 45 employees drove their own vehicle to the training. The parking lot was full, and some had to park in an overflow area or on the street. The admins were livid on Monday when they got 45 mileage sheets turned in and found out how expensive a last minute mandatory training could be. The third story is called Office Revenge. A is an executive assistant for the CEO. While she works mostly for one person, there's an executive team that she also does some work for. And one of these is C. C is the epitome of the office Karen. She takes great joy in being condescending, rude, taking credit for everyone else's work, and throwing people under the bus. Difficult to work with is a bit of an understatement. When A first started working there, C reported her to her boss for attitude on a number of occasions, when all A was doing was trying to hide her frustration, because C was deliberately being obtuse and making A's life unnecessarily difficult. A's boss is well aware of the friction. However, C is actually very good at her job, and she's clever enough to not cross lines that will get her in deep trouble. A decided if she couldn't beat them, she'd join them, in the best and most subtle possible way. Earlier this week, A ensured her boss overheard her talking to a client, praising C to the heavens. It was actually a real client call, not faked. When she hung up, her boss praised her for being the bigger person and talking up C, Despite their relationship, when C came in, the boss made a special mention to her that A had been praising her, while A just sat there smiling innocently at her. C was not happy about this, but couldn't do or say a thing without looking like a jerk. To put the cherry on top, the following morning, A greeted her with, "C, you look so tired. Are you okay? Can I make you a coffee?" C said no and stomped into her office. Every time she came out, A proceeded to say, "You really don't look well. Are you sure you are okay? Is there anything I can do for you?" Meanwhile, A's boss overheard all of these exchanges and once again praised her for setting aside the differences and trying to make things work. By the end of the day, C was visibly seething and A was the boss's new favorite. The last story is called Fired for Sitting. Many years ago, I worked for a large grocery chain that goes by several names, depending on what part of the country you are in. We had a cashier who had surgery about 3 weeks earlier, and he had a hard time standing for a long time. So he did the obvious thing and brought in a stool to rest on while he worked. The manager said he couldn't have a stool and would need to get rid of it, because the company policy said no sitting while clocked in, evidently not even on breaks. The cashier tried and failed to finish his shift and ended up leaving early. He did this a couple of times and was eventually fired for poor work performance. Now, I worked as a night crew stocker, which means I unload the truck, load up the go bags and stock the aisles. I also took out all of the trash for the admin offices. While I was cleaning the offices, I removed every chair I could find and loaded them into the go bags truck. I also printed out a letter in bold wording to the effect of, "All employees are reminded they are not to sit while clocked in." No one knew it was me because we were always short-staffed and I usually loaded the go bags truck myself. The next night the manager came in and exploded at the disrespect and yada yada yada. He ordered a new chair, but it didn't arrive for a couple of days. And no new chairs came to replace the others, just his. So I shipped it back again. This time they caught me the next day, but the chair was already gone. I was fired and they were threatening me with petty theft and whatnot. But since I had just shipped the chairs to the warehouse, they didn't really have a leg to stand on. Thanks for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please don't forget to leave a like, comment and subscribe. And if you have time, watch another one of my videos. And now, I hope you have a great day. See you soon. Bye bye.